Welcome to the GCN Tech Show.
This week, we've got loads, including a new high-tech continuous blood glucose monitor, new decathlon bikes, your upgrades, the bike vault, and our main talking point.
We take a look at some hot or not cycling tech on Kickstarter.
Let's do it. First up, the results of our poll from last week, in which we asked you about what you thought about the recent changes to the UCI's rule pertaining to frame design, and would it be a positive thing for the bike industry? Well, it would appear that 52% of you believe that it would be. So you can have really thin down tubes, really thin steep tubes.
I thought it'd be way more than that.
Well, 11% said no, and 37% were like, well, I don't know. So maybe there's people on the fence. Yeah. But yeah, on balance, most people welcome it, which is good to see. I think it could be really positive for bike design, personally. But on to our main talking point this week, and we're talking about the hottest or notest products on Kickstarter. Now, for those who are unfamiliar, Kickstarter is a platform, a website, which allows people to get investment from public crowdfunding in order to make their idea a reality, in order to turn just concepts into real products that you or I can buy.
Now, Kickstarter is open to some brilliant ideas and some, well, not so brilliant ideas. And we love seeing some of the crazy ideas that see the light of day and some that don't quite see the light of day.
Yes, we've been trawling for the best cycling Kickstarters, and I'm going to kick things off with this 360 VR Fit. What do you think of that?
Interesting.
In a nutshell, it is a virtual reality game that enables you to convert any indoor training experience into a virtual reality world of fun. So, for example, if you had a treadmill or a rowing machine, or in our case, a static bike or turbo trainer, you can wear the headset and then, you know, do your workout like you're outdoors.
And it is very high tech. There's two little sensors that you stick underneath your pedals. You stick on with Velcro, actually.
Yeah, well, very high tech. I mean, it does look like it could actually be a cool idea, especially for those who are stuck indoors and can't work out outside. But I do question how hot it would be wearing that big band thing on your head.
I feel like it'd give me a headache.
Yeah, if you were doing intervals, maybe not.
Shaking it around.
Yeah, maybe there might be a few issues there. But when I'm doing really hard intervals on the turbo train, I don't think that would stay on my head.
No, probably not.
Yeah, or John Degenkolb, he'd struggle.
Okay, moving on. What about these two products? These gained backing and they continue to be sold to this day. The Kinect Suspension Seat Post and Stem. And they gained backing 2014, so 6 years ago.
That's 6 years ago. Yeah. And still going quite strong and still apparently selling. They raised over $94,000 in their Kickstarter campaign.
Did well.
Yeah, so quite a lot. And for those who are unfamiliar, it's quite a novel design for suspension that can be built into your stem and your seat post, should you want it, if you're going to be riding over, you know, really rough roads.
I feel like this would be good in like Paris-Roubaix or a race like that. Definitely need some suspension.
Which raises the question, why haven't we seen any pros using this system in Paris-Roubaix? Well, I think looking at it, around 2014, it was quite a novel design on road bikes, but a lot of the big bike brands, they've developed their own systems. Like we see, you know, the Specialized Future Shock in the stem of their Roubaix, and we've seen more compliance built into other parts of the bike. Pinarello had their little shock in the back of the K10. But also, a lot of riders don't even use any suspension at the Paris-Roubaix because they don't feel it's necessary.
Just hardcore, aren't they?
Yeah, but clearly there is a market for this because it's continuing to be sold to this day. Just probably not amongst pro riders. Yeah. Now, there's plenty of other wacky ideas on Kickstarter, lots of weird and wonderful things, including this saddle, which has done remarkably well. It's called the Reprieve, and it aims to reduce pressure on your soft tissues and perineum. And clearly, quite a lot of people seem to agree that it does, as well, it appears to have sold quite a few.
Or what about this glove by Lofi? It's basically a glove with a smiley face on it, and it raised nearly 29K.
Yeah.
Keeping all things positive. Any negativity you get out on the road, just wave a smiley hand at them.
Yeah. It's like, meet negativity with positivity.
Exactly.
like we do here at GCN. Like it. What about this then? The Velo Visor. This is a visor that you can stick onto your helmet to give yourself a visor. I mean, it's pretty, does what it says on the tin.
Is it aero?
It doesn't look especially aero.
No.
It's also, but it doesn't seem to have gained a huge amount of traction either. It doesn't seem to have been a big success.
Just raised £400.
I tell you what though, if they made it a bit longer, it would work as PPE.
COVID secure.
Yeah, which could be quite useful now. Could be a COVID
visor. True, maybe they'll make it longer.
Yeah.
Now on the subject of helmets, Ollie, check this one out. This is the RH1 Performance Cycling Helmet. It's got MIPS in it, it weighs 375 grams, and it has a 4K camera built into it, one at the front and one at the back.
Nice. Do you know, I think that actually looks really cool.
Yeah, I like this one
and
too.
And I like the way that the cameras are sort of discreet. They're sort of hidden and nicely contained within the helmet. It just looks like a normal cycling helmet.
And it doesn't weigh that much, seeming as it has a camera in it. I thought it'd be a lot more.
Yeah, and it can actually broadcast your rides back to your friends as well.
So your friends can watch your ride?
Yeah, they can join you on your ride.
That's very entertaining.
Yeah. Yeah, I think it's actually quite a cool bit of tech, though, to be honest. And I think there's a definite market for people who want cameras built into helmets because of a safety concern.
Definitely but also, for commuters.
Yeah, commuter market. But then also people who are just really rad and
Rad.
Yeah, and want to, you know, film extreme descents and stuff and that kind of thing. It can look really cool.
Yeah.
So nice. Well, what about finally this? Check this out. This is a Tron bike.
Like a Zwift Tron bike.
Like a real one.
A real one.
So yeah, this is a complete Tron bike. It's got integrated everything. The wheels, hubless, right? They light up as well. I mean, it is basically a Tron bike, but it's real life.
I can't make my mind up about this.
Yeah?
I mean, you look at it and it screams gimmick, but then it has got some cool features on it. But yeah, I'm not sure.
It's 11 and a half kilos, but that doesn't matter because it's an e-bike. Yeah, that's cool. I mean, it's... Yeah.
I feel like the Tron bike should stay in the Zwift world.
If you get the premium version, you get an automatic gearbox as well. It's got 18 gears.
You can flip the handlebars round if you want sport mode or comfort mode as well. Yeah.
Well, I mean, with everything being integrated on it, it doesn't look like it's going to be an especially friendly bike to have to work on if you've got a maintenance problem or, heaven forbid, if you get a puncture. I have no idea how you change a puncture on a bike with hubless rims. Yeah, plus also, can you imagine the UCI getting their hands on that?
That will not be approved in a million years.
With their tape measures and their book of rules.
Yeah.
First up on Hot Tech this week, we have got the Super Sapiens Blood Glucose Live Monitor. This is a really cool and exciting bit of tech. It's actually been used by teams Jumbo Visma and Canyon SRAM. And the idea behind it is that you wear a little sensor on your arm, which is able to continuously measure your blood glucose and your response to different foods over a period of 14 days, and then that communicates to a corresponding app on your smartphone.
So how is this useful for cyclists?
Well, by being able to monitor your blood glucose continuously, you know, it's not just something that in the past has been seen for diabetics. We're increasingly seeing through research that everyone's response to different foods is actually different and very unique. So in the past we've said things like, you know, if you eat slow release carbs and fast release carbs, you know, you'll get spikes in insulin. But what we're actually finding is that something like you know, oats, porridge, some people that will spike their insulin, other people it won't. And you know, these top athletes and other people stand to gain by working out which foods their body better responds to so that then they can fuel more efficiently. It can also be useful in weight loss as well by avoiding insulin spikes and things like that.
I never really thought of that when I was an athlete, but missed out on a trick there, didn't we?
Yeah, well, I think we're going to see this kind of technology exploding over the next few years for not just athletes, but also for people who are trying to control their weight and lose weight.
Next up, Decathlon have announced they will be overhauling their mid to high range Van Rysel bikes.
Yes, they're venturing further into the ever popular gravel sector with the new Van Rysel EDR-CF. It's a carbon fiber gravel bike with full Shimano GRX components on there. And it comes in at £1,700, which is a great spec for the price. You've got the Ultegra GRX rear mech on there and GRX Shimano tubeless ready wheels as well.
They have also announced the EDR AF road bike with 105 coming in at under a grand, and that is a really good price for a really a decent bike.
Yeah, very competitive. Nice to see that that bike also has a user-friendly threaded bottom bracket and rim brakes and not disc brakes. Mm.
There's also a top-of-the-spec bike coming in at the end of this year of the Ultra, and coming in at a price of £3,799. G-Race Fulcrum Zero Racing Wheels, and coming in at claimed weight of 6.6 kilograms.
Yeah, which I think for that price, that's a great pretty spec, good, yeah. Isn't it? Mm. Fulcrum has released a new set of wheels called the Wind 75 DBs. As the name alludes, they're 75 millimetres deep, so very deep, and designed for time trial and triathlon applications. They're also tubeless ready out of the box and require no rim tape because of the rim's design and construction, which is a really nice feature and the way that more modern wheels are starting to head now, which is good to see. And they're disc brake only as well, which is kind of also alluded to in the name, yeah.
They come in at a weight of 1,820 grams, and the price for the wheel set would be 1,271 euros. Not bad.
Nice, yeah. Also, I forgot to say, but the width, in case you're wondering, 27 millimetres wide.
I was wondering that.
Yeah, so quite wide. Anyway, more hot tech next week.
Cha-ching! It's now time for Screw Around Upgrades by Upgrades, where you submit upgrades that you've made to your bikes or cycling lives for a chance to win the ultimate prize.
What is it?
A GCN cap. I thought you were meant to model it today.
I've left it at home.
Great. You had one job, Ollie. Anyway, before we get on to this week, let's take a look at last week's results. Ollie?
Yep, last week we had JPrez 1106. And his BMC Aero upgrade versus Adam J. Palmer 91's Aesthetic Tarmac SL4 build. Ooh. And the winner of
drum
the
drum roll, please.
Was JPrez and his BMC 67% comprehensively beaten.
Nice.
There. But yeah, both nice upgrades. And get in contact with Facebook and your cap will sort it out. Nice.
Send
one.
The cap
right.
To you.
Yeah. So, first up this week, we have got Nutcase 7. The seventh nutcase, who said that he managed to find this bike used on a bike forum. He said it was a decent frame, well used, but the wheels and the other components were pretty shot and worn out. So he did a bit of upgrading and servicing. That's what we like to hear. He changed out the following: the headset, the force crank and BB. He put a gold chain on there. He also put a new set of hubs, some GP5000 tyres, a new saddle, some new campy brakes, some new bar tape, new cable clamps, new brake levers, and extra bottle cages for long rides. Ooh, what do you think to that?
I quite like the wheels that were on there before, but he did say they were a bit run
shot
down.
And worn out, yeah. I mean, he says that he admits that with the bottle cages on there, it's not as kind of clean a look as it was before.
And pink handlebar tape with red, lots of red on. Bit of a clash, but...
Yes.
There
is a bit of a clash going on with the thing. I do like... It looks like he's got a spur cycle bell on the handlebars there. They are the coolest bells. If you're going to get a bell on your bike, the spur cycle ones, they're like a Zippo lighter of bells. They're cool.
Is that a saddlebag in the frame?
It's a top tube bag mounted like what a triantelope would use, but mounted on in an unconventional position.
It works.
From what I can tell. Yes, that saddle. We need to talk about that saddle, Manon.
It looks a bit painful.
It doesn't look the most comfortable.
No.
It does look like
you need a good pair of padded shorts with that.
Yeah. He's a nutcase. That's Nutcase's choice of saddle. Okay, great upgrade. Who is Nutcase 7 up against, Manon?
Well, he's up against Alex from Bristol, living in Christchurch, New Zealand. Picked up a Klein Quantum frame to build a new roadie. Got a mystery donor bike at the police auction without even seeing it, and it turned out pretty great. Got himself a SRAM Red 10-speed group set, some oval concepts, and some good other bits on there too.
I tell you what, you go up to a police auction not knowing what you're going to get, I'd be pretty happy if I managed to pick up a Klein
frame.
It's
a hit and miss, isn't it? Isn't it like the colours on the frame?
Yeah, it's very nice. They're very revered Klein frames. Yeah. I think he'd be very pleased with that. Also, I'm a big fan of the old SRAM 10-speed red. That's a cracking group set.
Yeah, definitely.
I think that's... I'm pretty sure that would have been the group set that was used to win the tour by Contador and such a like back then.
I had
double check that, but I'm pretty sure it was.
I had that on one of my first race bikes as well.
It's a very light group set, wasn't it? With the
double
tap on there.
Yeah, I was a hill climber. Anyway, bit of a chimney on there though.
Yes.
Bit of a chimney.
Yeah, and I'm not too sure about the white Ritchie stem as well. Slight clash, but still.
Not as much as pink and red.
Yeah, but cracking, still a cracking upgrade and a cracking job of going to police auction. It makes me think that we should perhaps even go and do a video where we go to a police auction and try and get...
And knowing us, we'll get something...
Rubbish.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't think we'll drop onto a Klein. But yes, it's not up to us. Vote in the app on the poll. You can click on in the link and you decide which upgrade is the best this week. Time now for our favourite bit of the show, the Bike Vault, where you submit pictures of your bikes and we judge them to be either nice or super nice. If they're super nice, what happens, Manon?
The belt gets round.
And they're in the Bike Vault forever. And as ever, you can also vote on the bikes themselves using the GCN app and decide if you think they're nice or super nice. But whatever we say is final, really. Anyway, first up this week...
Before we start, you've got a bit of hair that's really distracted me. That's better. Carry on.
First up this week, we have this bike from the rather catchily named P7 AXCP8XTN. And it is a Java Siluro 3. What do you think of that?
It's nice, but it's just a shame that the bike's the wrong way around.
Ay, dear, oh dear. Non-drive side. I mean...
It's a very nice looking bike, though.
That's a cool location as well. What a fantastic looking place. It looks quite a windy place. There isn't a location on there, but...
I'm going to say, like... Singapore.
Yes, could be. I think that's a good guess. Maybe that's Howlung Bay. I don't know. Anyway, nice. For the infraction.
Yeah, I'd say nice as well.
Yeah, non-drive side. Yeah. Who've we got next?
Next up, we've got
Sunarshan? I think it's Sunarshan, yes.
With a Canyon Endurance CF-SL8.
Yes. What do you make of that?
Nice. Do you like the colour scheme? Bit of matte black.
I do like that.
No chimney.
I like the matte frame with the gloss black logo. Yeah. I'm a bit of a sucker for that. I always think it looks quite nice.
And the bottle.
Smart.
I mean, it's a bottle, but still it matches the bike.
Yeah, it matches. Valves not aligned.
And the cranks.
Not in biggie smalls. Cranks all over the place.
Nice.
Where on earth is... What is that sign? Sentosa. The state of fun.
I want to go there. Eat and drink.
I'm actually going to Google where Sentosa, the state of fun, is.
Walk, jog, cycle.
Singapore.
Is it?
Yeah. Sentosa, the state of fun, is an island in Singapore. However, again, just too many infractions there.
Yeah. Is that a potential?
It's a nice.
Got potential.
It's a nice. Should have been a super nice. It's a nice. D. Kelly Ezzy.
Ooh.
With a specialised alloy.
And something else.
Yes. What? I like cars, but I'm not sure what that is. It's not something that we commonly see here.
I mean, it's still very nice.
Europe. Please let me know in the comments section what kind of car that is. I'm struggling to actually.
Super nice for the car.
Also, I like the way that he's matched the tyres of his bike.
With the car.
With the car. Mm. He's put the valves in the correct position, he's put the cranks. It looks like he's got a nice sort of two-tone KMC chain on there. Really has taken care of his bike. I can see it's in good condition, it's well maintained. Look at the wheel logos are nicely matched up as well.
Nice looking water bottles as well. Water bottles?
Cages. They fit with the bike, don't they?
Yeah.
I think, do you know what? I think that is a super nice.
Yeah?
Yeah. Yeah, as someone who takes pride in their equipment and looks after it.
The car or the...
Both.
Both. Fit super nice.
Yes, hopefully not the last this week. Randy J. Texan, hill climbing gravel bike. It's a Holdsworth Mystique. What do you make of that, Manon?
There's a lot going on. We've got big saddlebags, big water bottles. We're not a biggie smalls, crank,
there's
valves. And I feel like it's when you take a bike, it has to be this angle, not this angle.
Yeah, I think that's it's a rushed job. If a job's worth doing...
Do it properly.
Yeah, then that's it. I think, again, it's a nice for the Holdsworth.
Yeah.
Which is a shame, because it is a really nice looking bike. And I do like the orange and the black.
It's a nice frame, yeah.
Certainly is. Finally this week, Jay Kizzle has submitted...
Ollie, what is this?
Oh dear, oh dear. We go away.
How did this make it in?
We go away for 1 week, Manon. We're just in Italy for 1 week and we come back to this. What on earth is going on?
Mountain bikes do not belong in the bike vault. They have their own channel.
It's not even a nice. Sorry.
Very disappointing. Very.
Unbelievable. Unbelievable.
It's a nice colour though.
Yeah, golf. Nice golf colours. Yeah. Shame it's not a road bike. Yeah. Or a cross bike, or a gravel bike.
Or a time trial bike.
Yeah, or a touring bike.
Or a track bike.
Or any a fixie. Bike, yeah. A commuter. Mm. Could have been anything.
More bike fault next week.
Unfortunately, that brings us to the end of this week's show. Hope you've enjoyed it. And if you have, then please give us a thumbs up as it helps support the channel. And also, if you're into live racing, then check out the GCN Race Pass, as we do have loads of amazing races coming up still in what's left of the year. So the Vuelta just about to start, but territory restrictions do apply, so make sure you check what's available where you are. But in all territories, there is still short form highlights and the breakaway analysis show.
And if you fancy yourself some nice merch, a t-shirt, or maybe some GCN custom Castelli kit, head over to the GCN shop. Christmas is coming up, so treat yourself.
Oh, what are you getting me?
You've already got plenty. Greedy.